fed Lana the firefly in the room.
Hello, Hustle and friends, and welcome back to my channel. Today we have a very exciting video. I am really pumped because finally, after a big break of probably a month or so, I finally rescued a houseplant. Yes, you heard it right. So today I will share another happy rescue story. After that, we will go plant shopping in a big box store because my no buy is finally over. I was not buying plants for over 2 weeks, which is like, you know, I feel really pumped and proud of myself. But right now it just feels right, you know, just to go and check out, and who knows, maybe I will find something exciting, which I most of the time do in this big box store, so prepare for that. And then guys, I will buy some things for my collab coming up. So, oh my gosh, spoiler, next week I will share a collab with you, but about that we'll talk a little bit later. So, let's start with the houseplant rescue. So, I was walking my dog, you know, just chilling, having some, you know, relaxation time together, and we were walking past one, you know, point of a garbage containers, and next to a tree branch, all surrounded with doves and crows, because next to this spot was, you know, a bunch of breadcrumbs that people left for the birds, I found two cuttings of a ficus. To be specific, ficus alii. I'm not sure how to pronounce it. I will leave the name on the screen, obviously. I was seeing this ficus showing up in the big box stores just before the quarantine, and I was always eyeballing them, not going to lie. And I'm so happy that I just found some cuttings. I'm pretty sure that the person who left it was just probably, you know, forming the tree, maybe, and just cut off some, you know, extra branches and... was just cutting off some extra branches and left them outside for people to grab, which was a little bit risky because tonight was pretty cold outside. I'm not sure how this will go because the previous ficus that I rescued actually ended up dead. It was a very magnificent, it was huge ficus. I, you know, put so much effort into taking this plant home because it was enormous. I have a whole video about it. If you want to check it out, I will leave a link over here. What's up? Who's in the mood to play? You in the mood to play? You not there? You not there? You not there? What? Where was I? Anyway, let me show you the plants, right? So, these are the cuttings I found. I will insert right now the footage of when I found it. So, we're just on a walk with my dog, as you can tell, and just saw these leaves. And right now in Lithuania, it's still spring, and it's not usual to find some greenery outside yet. And when I saw it, I knew immediately that these are the cuttings from a tree that were grown in a home. So what will happen right now? I actually looked truly to the plant leaves. I washed it in a bath, obviously, so it will be clean and beautiful, you know. I let it dry out and it seems like it doesn't have any pests, you know, no problems on the leaves. So I will try to propagate them because, as you can tell, it's simple plain cuttings of branches, so there are no roots. So we will try to work on that. So let's do this, right? Let's do this. So I'll try to propagate them in water because most of the videos I have watched right now recommend propagating in water. So I have a glass with water. Okay, so I have my scissors. I just disinfected them with alcohol. So let's just do it. So this is, okay, let's do one by one. So this is the smaller branch. It's just a simple plain branch with no other branches, you know, just one stick with some leaves. So I'll try to cut it in two parts just in case, if you know, the bottom one won't work, you know. So, oh, right now I can see that it has a tiny branch over here, so I'll cut above that over here probably. Yep, just like I thought, it has sap, so please be careful if you're propagating something similar to this ficus. Most of the ficuses have some sap, you know. So this is cutting number one, this is cutting number two. So I will actually cut off bottom leaves so they won't stay in water, because when you put your cuttings into water with leaves, it's much more chance that they will just rot. So I'll take one and I'll take this one because it's really crinkly and not beautiful. We don't need that. So cutting number one looks pretty nice. I will let it actually dry while I will work with other ones. Looks cute, right? I just love those long, long leaves. How cool are they, right? Oh my gosh, this is probably one of the coolest leaves from ficuses that I can imagine. I actually love rubber plants or ficuses elasticus leaves, and this one is also really different and really awesome looking one. So I'm cutting off a couple bottom leaves as well in here, and it's left with some leaves. I think it should be working perfectly. Rocky, please don't cry. Oh my gosh, look at that. Just look at that. Oh my gosh, this cute thing. I will take this one, bigger one. So as you can tell, in here in the bottom, we have double cuttings. So I'll cut over here. Bam, like this. And probably I will leave this one as it is. I will once again cut the bottom leaves on it, so I know they won't stay in water. Maybe even one more, like that, right? Okay, so we have a bunch of cuttings. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay, so this looks like a decent chance for me to get one, at least one rooted, right? So I'll put all of them in the water. As you can tell, the bottom part doesn't have any leaves, so this is perfect. And exactly what I want. And as you can tell, none of the leaves are in the glass, right? So this is hopefully will work. Actually, guys, this is pretty crazy, but my house is filled with cuttings, and this is not really, you know, like me. I don't often take cuttings of my plants. I like to grow them, you know, as they are, you know, crazy, leggy, whatever. But I think I'm liking, and I'm getting into cutting my plants, which I don't know how sounds, but yeah. So anyway, I know that this ficus, as most of ficuses, love bright indirect light, so I'll keep it in this room because, as you can tell, it's pretty light in here. And well, stay tuned for an update because I'm excited. This is a very interesting looking cuttings, right? It's actually a pretty shame that I needed to cut so many leaves, but hopefully soon I will get more new ones on this plant. And this is about it for the first part. So right now, since we are done with the main business over here, right now we need to go to this big box store because, first of all, I need to buy things for the collab I was talking about, and I also want to take a look on the plants. So I'll take you along. We will go plant shopping, you know, maybe find some cool looking plants. This shop most of the time have crazy cheap prices on the plants, so I think you should enjoy this part. So without further ado, let's go and see what we'll have in the shop. Let's do this. Look at this weird orchid. Wow. It's the first time I see things like this. This is so cool. Gosh, look at this color. And only tick. Так, стало гряже. Wow. Guys, look at this burgundy color. Oh my gosh. I think this is the one that's coming home with me. Gorgeous. Guys, look at these blue ones. Oh gosh. I hope you know that this is not real. This is actually a ink that was spotted in the water that was watered with. So, do you hear me with this mask? Ouch. I always loved these palms. They're so gorgeous, but I already killed two.
which is a shame, because they're beautiful, right? Look at this philodendrons Brazil, guys. So gorgeous. And all of them are only 6 euros. Oh gosh. The beautiful plant. Oh no, plant police. Call the plant police, people. What the hell? Golden? Are you for real? Oh. This is painful. Oh, look. This is beautiful, isn't it? What a gorgeous aloe. I think I want this one too. Go big or go home, isn't it?
Go home.
Okay guys, I'm finally back home, and this was kind of fail because as we started to film with my boyfriend, I already started, you know, to pick plants I want to buy. The staff member from the store came to us and chat and said madly, please stop taking photos, you can't take photos in here. And we said, well, we are filming, not taking photos. And she was like, no, you cannot do this, please hide the camera. And she was really mad and intense. So we did not film too much footage for you guys, and I'm really sorry about it, but I hope you still had a sneak peek to the store. And guys, I came back home with 2 beautiful plants, so right now I will show you a haul of plants I got. I was actually so surprised because once again the shop was filled with new plants, and I was in the store I think maybe 2 or 3 weeks ago, and already then I was so surprised with the specimen they have. And guys, this time they managed to surprise me as well, so I came back with really cute plants. Let's start from the more simple one and let's finish with a bang. So let me grab them. Okay, so this is a first plant. This is an aloe, and I just adore this kind of aloes. I think they're just perfect for fairy gardens. Bam. Okay, so this is a beautiful, beautiful aloe, and I think it will work perfectly for a fairy garden. I'm actually thinking about doing one extra, extra exciting and cute, so stay tuned for that. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please don't forget to subscribe, to like, to comment. Back to the video. So this will go to the fairy garden for sure, maybe, probably, I think so. It was 2 euros and some cents, I'm not sure right now. And guys, just look at those chunky roots. Holy smokes, guys, this is adorable and so cute. And there was maybe 8 pots of these, and I obviously grabbed the largest one and the craziest one because I love how the leaves are facing very different ways, and it's cute. It's really, really cute, and I adore it. I actually had this one, I think maybe last summer, but I killed it because I overwatered it. And right now, since I see that the root system is so chunky, I know that this plant saves the water inside of these chunky roots, so I'll be more careful with watering it. And I think it will be a very, very nice addition to my collection. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. Look at this monster. It looks like an octopus. So cute, right? And another one, guys, another one. I'm so sorry if in this video I'll be really exposed. I'm not sure what's going on with my camera, but if it is and I look horrible, please, sorry. If you have been on my channel for at least a couple months, you will know that I love orchids, and my love for them is growing and growing every single day. And this time I could not leave without an orchid. I was so sure if I won't find any cool ones, I will come home with at least Phalaenopsis with beautiful blooms. Since right now Easter, well, at least tomorrow will be Easter, so for those who will celebrate this Easter, happy Easter, guys. Have a nice, beautiful eggs. I hope you'll enjoy decorating them and just will have a beautiful time with your family and friends. So guys, when I was in the store, I was so excited to buy a plant with blooms since it feels like real spring over here. I was not disappointed at all because I found beautiful Paphiopedilums once again. And you know how much I love them. You can see a couple of them in the background. I love their blooms. I love the foliage. But this time I got a little bit different one, and I was not sure if I will ever enjoy this one, but this particular one is so beautiful, and without further ado, let me show you. So first of all, let's appreciate this beautiful bloom. Just look how creamy, how yellow it is, right? I love these colors. These ones are actually so autumn looking colors, right? but I just love it. I love the other side of the bloom, which is really beautiful as well. And it's just gorgeous, and it's actually hairy. So if you will look close enough, you will see little tiny hairs in the middle of the bloom over here, which is so, so cool, right? So this is the bloom, and this is the whole plant. So in this pot, I have three Paphiopedilums, and why this particular one bought my heart? Because of the foliage back. Just look at this, guys. Look how cool this looks. I love these purple edges, and I just love how in here it's so, so purple, and in here slowly it goes greener and greener, and only big purple stripe in the middle is left on the leaf. This is so cool, and the front of the leaves looks simply green, so it's a very interesting contrast, and I just could not leave this store without it, guys. So this was such a cool find in my opinion, and I'm so, so proud. I cannot wait to repot it, because I think this will be such a nice contrast to the ones I already have, and my orchid collection is growing. I actually just recently filmed an orchid collection video, so if you want to check it out, I will leave a link over here, you can go in and watch it. But yes, this is my newest addition to collection, and I am in love, guys. I actually don't know the specific name of Paphiopedilum. As you can tell on the label, it only says Paphiopedilum, and that's it. It was €10.69, which I think is crazy for Paphiopedilum, right? I am so, so surprised, and once again, so happy that I can find such, you know, uncommon plants for Lithuania, where I live, for such awesome prices. So this just, you know, blows my mind. So guys, this is another and last plant from my haul. I really love it. I love how you hear this bloom is even from another side. If you will look close enough, you will see tiny hair everywhere. It's so fluffy. I love that all stems on my all Paphiopedilums are so fluffy. It's almost the same as touching my dog Rocky. Just, it's cute. Okay guys, and this is it for today's video. I'm so happy that I was able to take you along. Sorry that I missed my previous upload. I actually had a messy week and it was insane. But right now I feel good. Actually today I will film 3 videos, so this is a little bit nerve-wracking for me, but at the same time I'm so, so excited for the opportunity to do a collab with this another plantuber that I am sure you all will love if you don't know her yet. So this will be so much fun, so stay tuned on my channel for the collab video, which will be up really, really soon. And before finishing the video, as always, let's get to the tradition. Since we have faced a mean lady today, I wanted to make it as a joke lesson today, and I will teach you how to say angry or mean lady in Lithuanian and in Russian. So, if you want to say mean or angry lady in Lithuanian, you need to say pikta moteris. Once again, pikta moteris. And if you want to say mean or angry lady in Russian, you need to say zlaya zhenshchina. Once again, zlaya zhenshchina. Sounds mean, right? So yes, guys, this is about it. Thank you so much for joining on today's adventure. I am pretty sure that this video was filled with lots of different action related to plants. So let's all chat in the comment section down below. What do you think about my houseplant rescue? What do you think about my haul? And let's all have a nice chat before, you know, meeting up with family and friends if you can. I mean, the world is crazy right now, right? But anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel, and I hope to see you in my next one. Bye!